Welcome back. Because statistics is a very important tool in quality control, so today I would like to give a brief overview of statistical distribution. Most of the case, when you want to monitor the behavior of your batch of productions, you need to measure certain properties. If you measure every part of this batch, you will get a population distribution. They are two important statistics to represent the distribution of your population. The first one is called mean, and the second one is called variance. But in most of the case, we don't have such resource to measure every part in this batch. We will only measure some samples and try to use these samples to predict the behavior of the whole batch, which is the population. This is called sample mean and sample variance. Like here, we only use 5 samples and try to use the distribution of these 5 samples to predict the population behavior. Although there might be some errors, but this is a very cost-efficient way. This is how you calculate the mean and the standard deviation. The mean is very intuitive. Basically, you just sum up all the properties of your instance. If you are measure every instance in your population, this is called population mean. If you use only some samples to calculate the mean, this is called sample mean. And the mean will be the summation of the output divided by the number of samples. The square of standard deviation is called variance. The equation of variance is shown here. If you are talking about population variance, this will be the square deviation of output y with the mean value and divided by the total number of samples. If you are measuring sample variances, then this is the square deviation of the output y and the mean output divided by m minus 1, where m is the number of samples. Why do we use m minus 1 in the sample variance? They is related to the expected values in statistics. Using this equation, we will get an unbiased estimation of sample variances. We often use standard deviation, and standard deviation is a square root of the variance. Using Excel, it will be very easy to calculate the sample average and the standard deviations. You may use this equation and try that by yourself. Most of the case, we will use normal distribution to describe the distribution of your properties. This is the property density function of normal distribution, where S is the standard deviation, Y bar is the mean of your data. So this distribution will look like a bear shape, and it's symmetric. The mean will control the center of your distribution, and the standard deviation sigma will control the width of your distribution. Like the graph here, for a larger standard deviation, the distribution will be flatter and wider. For a smaller standard deviation, your distribution will be narrower and higher. So if you have a higher standard deviation, most of the case will stands for your distribution has a low quality. If you have a smaller distribution, which means that your output is very consistent. In the old days, we will use tables, try to find out what is the distributions. And this is a very typical table that you can find in many textbooks. This is called cumulative probability for standard normal distribution. Standard normal distribution is a normal distribution with mean equal to 0 and the standard deviation equal to 1. Say this is the distribution. So the cumulative probability is the shaded area where z is smaller than this given number. Using this table, you can easily find out the cumulative probability for a standard normal distribution. But nowadays, it's very easy to access computers. Using Microsoft Excel, you can use this equation to find out the numbers you need as well. But I still want to give a brief overview about how to use this table to obtain the number you want. Assume you want to find out what is the cumulative probability from minus infinity to minus 1.23 for a standard normal distribution. You can use the table to find out the value. This table is showing alpha, z alpha. If you want to find the number up to minus z alpha, so you check out the number here. This is the first digit and the first decimal, and here is the second decimal. So we want to find out the cumulative probability for z smaller than minus 1.23. You need to check the table for 1.23. Here is 1.2. And the second decimal will be looking up here, 3. So the cumulative probability for minus 1.23 will be 0.1093. Using the previous example, if you want to find out the probability for z greater than 1.23, like here, you will find out the probability will be the same as the probability smaller than minus 1.23 because of the symmetric property of normal distribution. In quality control, there's a very good chance you want to find out what is your distribution within a certain range, especially within the multiple of standard deviation. For standard normal distribution, the standard deviation is 1. So how to find out the distribution probability for your value z within 1 and minus 1? You can use the previous table to find out a result. What is the probability for standard normal distribution to be within 1 and minus 1? How to use the given table to find out the value? This is the cumulative probability for minus infinity to a minus number z. So for the y to be within 1 and minus 1, which can be the probability of cumulative probability for y smaller than 1 minus y smaller than minus 1. What is the probability for y smaller than minus 1? You can check out the table 1.0, and the second decimal is also 0, so the corresponding value will be 15.87%. So this is the cumulative probability for minus 1 over here. How do you get the probability for y smaller than 1? You can use a symmetric property for normal distribution. Since it is normal distribution, so the probability for y greater than 1 will be the same as the probability for y smaller than minus 1. You can use this kind of property to calculate what is the probability for y smaller than 1, which is 1 minus the cumulative probability for y smaller than minus 1. So substitute the number over here, you can get the probability within 1 and minus 1. Between 1 and minus 1 will be 68.26. Same thing, if you want to find out what is the probability within 2 and minus 2, and 3 and minus 3, you can use the similar method. Here, 1 stands for the standard deviation. The probability for y between 2 and minus 2 actually is the probability between 2 times of standard deviation and minus 2 times of standard deviation. It's not always your distribution is standard normal distribution. What if your distribution has a mean mu and a standard deviation sigma, like the blue line over here? Then you won't be able to use the previous standard normal distribution table to find out the cumulative probability you require. Certainly, if you are using Microsoft Excel function, it won't be a problem. However, I still want to show you these classic techniques to normalize your variable into standard normal distribution and use the previous table to find out the corresponding probabilities. What is the normalization techniques? Assume your variable is y and mean mu and standard deviation sigma. You can use this equation to normalize your variable y into z, and z will be the standard normal distribution. What does it mean for this normalization? You minus y by mu, like you are moving your distribution from here to centered at zero. Then your distribution will have the mean zero by minus all the output y by the mean value. Next, you divided this number by sigma. It's kind of resizing the width of your distribution in such a way that your standard deviation will become 1. So after these divisions, your distribution will look like this red line, and this red line distribution will be a standard normal distribution. Using these techniques, if you want to find out what is the probability of y smaller than y sub alpha, you just need to find out the corresponding value of z for y sub alpha using this normalization equation, which is over here. Then you can use the previous table to check out what is the cumulative probability of z smaller than these numbers, and then you can get your answer. Therefore, if you look at a normal distribution with mean mu and a standard deviation sigma, you will find out that the probability of y within 1 times of standard deviation will be 68.26, which is the same probability of z within 1 m minus 1. The same thing for the y within 2 times of standard normal distribution and 3 times of standard normal distribution. This is a very useful tool to understand the distribution property of a normal distribution. This is the Excel function normdist, where you can use this function to calculate the cumulative probability. And here, the norm inverse, you can use these commands to find out the number of x, which the corresponding cumulative probability is equal to the number you specify here.